AJ, or BG, whatever his name is. Like, I don't think BG's bad. He has God tier AoE. I just think his damage sucks.
His damage, and he's really slow.
God, it's turned on Xenoverse.
Wait, didn't already do this level?
Like, his AoE's really good, it's just his damage sucks.
Oh my god, how the hell did I survive that? I feel like I beat this level before. Am I cracked out? Am I on crack? It just depends on who you
Like, there's the arena fighters that are really good. Like, I've heard Demon Slayer competitively is actually pretty solid.
That netcode is boo-boo, bro. That shit's so bad.
The netcode sucks, though.
That shit is so ass, bro.
I've heard, obviously Stormwind had a big competitive scene for a little bit. Kill la Kill, like, has some kind of in-depth combat from the bit I played in the demo.
Honestly, I think
there's shit like the what's it called? There's shit like the fucking Seven Deadly Sins game.
I have not seen anything about that game.
It's J-Stars but worse.
God damn it. I fucked up.
That's exactly
sorry.
How it plays. J-Stars but worse.
God, bro, what the fuck? Bruh. These jumps are so simple. But what I was gonna say about Kill la Kill, I really think Kill la Kill could have really grown if the series itself wasn't so niche.
Yeah, like honestly, when I got into Kill la Kill a few years back when the game was coming out, you know, I'm like, oh, it's gonna be typical, you know, edgy loot anime. No, it's really fucking good, honestly.
When the game was first released, I was like, hey yo, this is an easy cop. And then as like the
nobody
like
fucking talked about it.
Yeah, no one really talked about it, and then the game just suddenly released and I'm like, oh, okay. And then now it's like, why would I get it? Like what would be the point of me getting the game? Other than me just liking the show. Which, I mean, I guess that's worth it. I mean, to be completely honest, I've bought games for much lesser reasons. So, you know.
That is fair.
So I don't think it's bad that, like, I could just buy the game just because I like the show, but, like...
There's a new Shenron Wish?
Yeah, that's how you get Super Saiyan God.
Oh, I gotta get the fucking Dragon Balls?
Yeah.
How many do I have? Not skills, it's items.
Honestly, if you're able to stream the story mode, I might get it, honestly.
Four more Dragon Balls. What quest is the Dragon Ball quest again?
The Frieza one on Namek. The destroyed Frieza one.
Frieza Namek. Thank you, Kira. I think it's only $20. I think that's just, like, its permanent price is $20.
Oh, yeah, that's easy cop if I'm able to stream it. That's easy cop.
Let me look at it up really quick since I'm, you know, on. Bro, like, I want that
Fire
Warriors DLC so bad.
Bro, I'm gonna have so many games in my inventory that I won't even know what to do.
Two.
Okay, how the hell am I supposed to get those?
Yeah, it's permanent price is $20.
I'll bet. Oh, no!
Oh, I haven't seen this Parallel Quest screen in a long time.
Eldo, pray for me.
It's been a good minute. I shall pray. I'm praying.
Okay. Okay.
And remember how fun it was to use, remember how fun it was to use cast characters and everybody just played the CACs?
Yeah.
Or Gogeta. Or Vegito. Or Goku.
Bro, nobody played Vegito. What do you mean?
Vegito Blue, people played him for a good minute.
Oh, you meant Vegito Blue. Okay. I thought you meant base Vegito. I was about to say, who the fuck you know me and base Vegito?
Nope.
Well, I mean, yeah, but like, you know. Honestly, I think base Vegito's one of the best characters in the game, but like, you know.
He's pretty good.
Especially his Vegeta variant. Like, that nigga has Sledgehammer or Big Bang Attack. Like, bro, that...
As much shit as we give Xenoverse, there's one thing I always gotta give it. And that is, damn does this game get so much fucking support.
Yeah, I'm actually really surprised for how much this game's getting.
It's been 5 years.
It's actually insane.
Right, and it's still getting support. Like, by this time, everybody thought, oh, Xenoverse 3 is going to be out. No. Some people are saying, you know, Xenoverse might be, you know, like the new Cursed Dragon Ball franchise where we never get the wanted sequel. You know, like Tekaichi, we never got 4, and Raging Blast, we never got 3. Xenoverse 3 might never be a thing.
Okay, what the hell am I supposed to do with this boss fight?
I feel like Xenoverse 3 is going to be a thing eventually, but...
Okay, so you can't hit him.
Damn, it's definitely not looking like it.
Okay, so what do I do? Oh my god.
Xenoverse is still a great game. It's just the online and the PvP.
Oh shit.
What does it say if you get a Dragon Ball gun, isn't it? You got a key item?
Huh?
What does it say if you get a Dragon Ball gun, isn't it? You got a key item or some shit?
Yeah, it's a key item.
Or is it just you got a Dragon Ball?
It's key item.
For a few hours. Because now I want Super Saiyan God. Oh, there's more voting. Alright, what are we voting for this time?
God damn it. Oh.
Let's see what we're voting for this time. Into the characters and their outfit. Partner customization though and artwork though.
Bruh.
Yo, wait, Drew, this is cool as fuck.
Huh.
It's obvious he's probably gonna win, but someone out of the new Xenoverse voting shit, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, what partner do you want to be customized next? So it's God, Goku, Goten, Teen Gohan.
Oh, I'm voting for SS Day 4 Gogeta. That's what I'm voting
for. That's who I'm probably gonna vote for. I feel like that's the obvious winner. It's either him or like God, Goku. Or God, Vegeta.
I want him because he's my favorite Gogeta in the game, but his preset fucking sucks dick. This nigga has no good super attacks, but his ultimate, like, that's crazy.
Bro, remember, when he had to lock off to do really good damage?
Bro, what the bro. Okay.
Remember that shit, right?
Huh? What?
You had to lock off to do really good damage with Gogeta's ultimate.
I mean, it still does crazy-ass damage.
Mm-hmm. But it just does more damage if you lock off.
It's still a thing in Xenoverse too, ironically.
I know, that's what I'm saying. The pro, like, this game has a lot of content. That's something I gotta give it. It still has a lot of content.
Mm-hmm. suck, bro. Oh my god.
Games like Fighters, most definitely. But this game has a lot of content. Honestly, if it wasn't for the shitty online and the bullshit you can run into, I'd probably prefer this over Fighters just in there's so much to do.
I probably would agree with you.
Just because there'd be so much to do.
God damn it! Oh, fuck me!
Out of the main three, well, I guess four because we also have Xenoverse 1 on PS4. But I like the main Dragon Ball games on PS4. Xenoverse 2 has the most content. Pretty sure it probably has more content than Kakarot.
Oh, it definitely does. There's no contest.
Kakarot, after you beat the game, it's just a bunch of random side quests you're not gonna remember or care about. Until you get to the DLC. Then you beat the DLC, because the DLC is like... the first one's like an hour, the second one's probably two, and the last one was like probably four.
Shit.
Okay. I really hope they do Heroes content in Xenoverse. That would be really cool if they did that. Cause that's all they're really missing. It's just Heroes content.
Oh yeah, deadass.
Hey, I got a key item, let's go. Like, if Xenoverse got Heroes content, that'd be crazy.
Now how the hell am I supposed to time this up? Oh, there you go.
Because it's going that fucking route at this point. They're really running out of, like, main things from Dragon Ball to do. Because, I mean, the only thing they haven't really touched upon a lot is OG Dragon Ball, but they're not going to touch an OG Dragon Ball.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know why, bro. Like, it's OG Dragon Ball is
awesome, but bro. I guess it's because most people haven't seen it. I'm gonna guess.
Yeah, but like their main target audience is the Japanese, and they know what OG Dragon Ball is. Like, everybody in Japan knows what that is.